Namaskar, good evening. You are watching Rajya Sabha Television. I'm Smriti Rastogi with news tonight. Let's begin the bulletin with the top headlines. Opposition parties guided by selfish interests do not want a strong India or a strong armed force, says Prime Minister Narendra Modi at a public rally in Kanchipuram. Inaugurates projects related to roads, railways and electrification in state. Announces Centre's decision to rename Chennai Central Railway Station after former Chief Minister M.G. Ramachandran. Ayodhya dispute not an issue of land but sentiment and faith, says Supreme Court, calling it a matter of mind, heart and healing. Bench headed by Chief Justice reserves decision on referring case to court-appointed mediator. Swachh Sarvekshan Survey 2019 declares Indore cleanest city for the third year in a row. Bhopal judged cleanest capital city of the nation. Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand and Maharashtra named top three best performing states. Vice President Venkaiah Naidu meets a President and Vice President of Paraguay in Paraguayan capital city Asuncion, pays tributes to martyrs at the National Pantheon of Heroes. And Parliamentary Standing Committee asks social media platforms to tackle fake news, increase communication with Election Commission. Panel seeks detailed report from Facebook, WhatsApp and Instagram on the steps taken by them to safeguard user data. Our top focus tonight, Prime Minister Narendra Modi launched various development projects in Karnataka and Tamil Nadu during his day-long visit to the two states. Addressing a public rally at Kalaburgi in Karnataka, Prime Minister Narendra Modi stressed that development was high on the agenda of his government. Prime Minister Modi dedicated to the nation ESIC Hospital and Medical College in Bengaluru, super speciality blocks in KIMS, Hubli and Ladies Hostel for students from Northeastern region at Bangalore University. Prime Minister Modi laid the foundation stone for the BPCL Kalaburgi Depot and opened the Income Tax Appellate Tribunal in Bengaluru. He also interacted with the beneficiaries of Ayushman Bharat scheme at Kalaburgi in Karnataka.
पेट्रोलियम के रायचूर डिपो को विस्तार देने के लिए उसको कलबुर्गी में स्थापित किया जा रहा है। साथियों, इस पूरे क्षेत्र में पेट्रोलियम पदार्थों से जुड़ी आवश्यकताओं की पूर्ति के लिए रायचूर डिपो बहुत छोटा पड़ने लग गया था। यही कारण है कि पहले सिर्फ, याद रखना जरा, पहले सिर्फ 2.5 एकड़ में जो डिपो फैला था, अब वो 56 एकड़ से ज्यादा जमीन पर बनाया जा रहा है। ये 56 सुनते ही कांग्रेस वालों की नींद खराब हो जाती है।
Prime Minister Modi also unveiled several road and railway projects worth crores of rupees in Tamil Nadu. Prime Minister Modi laid foundation stones for 5 national highways projects and dedicated to the nation the 122-kilometre two-lane section of NH-38 falling in Vellore and a 32-kilometre four-lane section of NH-381 in Tirupur. The Prime Minister also dedicated to the nation the Ennore LNG terminal. He announced that the Chennai Central Railway Station will be renamed after MGR. Addressing a public rally, Prime Minister Modi lashed out at the opposition, saying they are guided by selfish interests and neither want a strong India nor strong armed forces.
In the upgradation of the power looms, more than 2 lakh looms have been upgraded in the country, of which more than 1,24,000 looms have been upgraded in Tamil Nadu alone. Kanchipuram and Tamil Nadu have a rich potential of tourism. We would be happy to know that the NDA government had done lots of work in the tourism sector. From 2013 to 2017, foreign tourist arrivals increased by a record 42%. Foreign exchange earnings increased by 50% from 2013 to 2017. To ensure more tourists arrivals, the e-visa facility is available to 166 nations.
And the Supreme Court today reserved its order on the Ayodhya land dispute case that whether the matter should be referred for mediation. A 5-judge constitution bench headed by Chief Justice Ranjan Gogoi said the case was not only about property but also about sentiment and faith. It added that it was conscious of the gravity of the land dispute and the outcome of mediation on the body politic of the country. The bench said, "We are not concerned about what Mughal ruler Babur had done and what happened after. We can go into what exists in the present moment. The apex court is considering whether the dispute can be settled through mediation." The top court had asked the contesting parties to give names of possible mediators who can be considered if it decides to refer the matter for mediation. 14 appeals have been filed in the apex court against the 2010 Allahabad High Court judgment.
आज अदालत ने दोनों पक्ष को की दलीलें सुनी. कुछ लोगों ने कहा कि मध्यस्थता में जानी चाहिए. हम लोगों ने मध्यस्थता का विरोध किया, यह कहते हुए कि उच्च न्यायालय के समक्ष इस मामले को काफ़ी प्रयास किया था कि मध्यस्थता हो दोनों पार्टी के पक्ष में, लेकिन मध्यस्थता फेल कर गई. हम लोगों का मानना है कि यह मध्यस्थता पुनः फेल कर जाएगा, इसीलिए कोर्ट का समय जाया करने के बजाय अच्छा है कि इस पूरे मामले का फैसला कोर्ट के द्वारा दी जाए.
The center told the Supreme Court on Wednesday that related to the Rafale aircraft deal have been stolen from the Defense Ministry, referring to a report published in the newspaper regarding the Rafale deal. Attorney General K.K. Venugopal said those who put documents on the Rafale deal in public domain are guilty under the Official Secrets Act and contempt of court. Venugopal said an investigation on the theft was going on. The Supreme Court bench was hearing a batch of petitions seeking a review of its December 14th verdict, dismissing all the pleas against the deal procured by India from France. Next hearing in the matter will be held on 14th of March. And more developments, President Ram Nath Kovind presented the Swachh Sarvekshan Awards 2019 on Wednesday. Indore was adjudged as the India's cleanest city for the third straight year, while New Delhi Municipal Council area was given the cleanest small city award. Uttarakhand's Gaucher was adjudged the best Ganga town in the central government survey. Addressing the gathering, President Kovind appreciated those who are taking active part in the cleanliness drive in the country. He said Mahatma Gandhi had played a pivotal role in spearheading the movement of cleanliness. President Kovind said there is a need to change the mindset of people towards cleanliness, as many people pay a lot of attention to personal hygiene and cleanliness at home, but not to public cleanliness. He said culture of cleanliness has to become an integral part of the lives of citizens.
स्वच्छता को प्रभावी और स्थायी बनाने के लिए जरूरी है कि यह सभी नागरिकों की आदत, स्वभाव और व्यवहार का हिस्सा बने. जीने का तरीका स्वच्छता पर आधारित हो, सोचने का तरीका स्वच्छता पर केंद्रित हो। बहुत से लोग व्यक्तिगत सफाई, अपने घर और परिसर की सफाई पर बहुत ध्यान देते हैं, लेकिन सार्वजनिक और सामुदायिक सफाई के प्रति उदासीन रहते हैं। इस मानसिकता में भी बदलाव लाना जरूरी है। सर्वत्र स्वच्छता ही प्रभावी स्वच्छता होती है। स्वच्छता की जड़ों को मजबूत बनाने के लिए स्वच्छता की संस्कृति को नागरिकों के जीवन का अभिन्न अंग बनाना होगा। स्वच्छता को लेकर लोगों में गर्व की भावना होनी चाहिए। इसके लिए जागरूकता बढ़ाने के प्रयासों पर और अधिक बल देना होगा। सभी विद्यालयों और उच्च शिक्षण संस्थानों में स्वच्छता को पाठ्यक्रम का महत्वपूर्ण विषय बनाना चाहिए। स्वच्छ भारत मिशन के परिणामों को स्थायी और प्रभावी रूप देने के लिए होलिस्टिक और सस्टेनेबल सैनिटेशन पर जोर दिया जा रहा है। किसी भी शहर या गांव के लिए खुले में शौच से मुक्त होना स्वच्छता की पहली पायदान है। स्वच्छता की सुविधाओं का निरंतर उपयोग, उनका समुचित रखरखाव, सॉलिड और लिक्विड वेस्ट का प्रबंधन, नदियों, झीलों और वाटर बॉडीज़ को मल प्रदूषण से मुक्त रखना सतत स्वच्छता के लिए जरूरी है। मुझे यह जानकर प्रसन्नता हुई है कि स्थायी स्वच्छता से जुड़े इन सभी पहलुओं पर ध्यान दिया जा रहा है और प्रगति भी हो रही है।
Housing and Urban Affairs Minister Hardeep Singh Puri said that the urban transformation that is being attempted in the country is the most comprehensive and ambitious framework of planned urbanization.
The urban transformation that is being attempted through the Prime Minister's flagship programs and the programmatic interventions is the most comprehensive and ambitious framework of planned urbanization being undertaken anywhere in the world. Today, ladies and gentlemen, is to assure you that whilst we have completed more or less the physical targets of this scheme, construction of individual household toilets, where we have reached a figure of 94% and will complete the 100% in the next month or so. Community toilets, 500,000, which we have already completed. And we are well towards completing the physical targets set for 2nd October 2019. But I believe this is the start of the journey.
And more developments of the day, Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu held delegation-level talks with Paraguay President Mario Abdo Benitez on Wednesday. The two sides held wide-ranging talks on strengthening bilateral ties between India and the Latin American country. They agreed to explore new areas of collaboration such as hydel and solar energy, health, traditional medicine, information and communication technology, farming, agriculture, machinery and biotechnology. Both countries welcomed the signing of MOU between the Diplomatic and Consular Academy, Ministry of Foreign Affairs of the Republic of Paraguay and the Foreign Service Institute, Ministry of External Affairs. President Abdo Benitez and Vice President Naidu also expressed concern over the global menace of terrorism. Condemning the February 14th Pulwama terror attack, the Vice President stressed on the need of an urgent adoption of the Comprehensive Convention on International Terrorism. The Paraguayan President said his country stands with India in its fight against terror. President Abdo Benitez also reiterated his country's support to India's candidature for a permanent membership at the United Nations Security Council. Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu also met his Paraguayan counterpart Hugo Velasquez. The vice presidents of both the countries released a commemorative stamp on Mahatma Gandhi. Earlier in the day, he visited the National Pantheon of the Heroes of Paraguay and saluted the valor and sacrifice of those who contributed to the progress of the country. And for more on this, we'll go across to our correspondent, Raj Kamal Rao, who is joining us from Paraguay. Raj, what were the big takeaways of Vice President M. Venkaiah Naidu's meeting with President and Vice President of Paraguay today?
Smriti, as you rightly pointed out, Vice President Naidu is the first Vice President to visit Paraguay. This is the first high-level delegation from India to this country. This is part of India's outreach to Latin American region. We've reported on Vice President's visit to Panama, Peru and Guatemala when he became Vice President. That was his first foreign visit after becoming and after assuming charge of Vice President. And today's visit assumes significance because in the last one and a half years, President and Vice President both together have covered the region and extending both cultural and business cooperation with the region, because the region has rich natural resources and mineral resources are available. This is an unexplored territory for India, especially the subcontinent itself. Maybe they are separated by a vast sea space, but the connectivity still remains the problem. But extending cultural cooperation, the spread of yoga, and also a comprehensive dialogue on eliminating terror from the region, and also extending support to India on its stance at the stands on terror and supporting India at UNSC were crucial points when VP met the President and the Vice President. He also invited a parliamentary delegation from the Paraguayan Parliament to visit and have a dialogue with the upper house of parliament, which is Rajya Sabha, where a Vice President of India is a chairperson. He's also slated to talk and hold a meeting with the business delegation here, where he's going to address and push India's agenda, reform agenda, the reform, perform, transform, which the Prime Minister has said. And he's going to push forth the agenda and invite the delegation and invite the business community to invest in India, and also vis-a-vis encouraging Indian businessmen to invest and explore the opportunities in this Latin American region, Smriti.
What will be the important programs on the itinerary of Vice President for the days ahead? Because Vice President, as we know, is on an 8-day visit to Paraguay and Costa Rica.
Since it's the two continents are very far, and Vice President had to have a stop at Madrid, tomorrow he is going to address the business delegation, and today evening, which is going to be early morning tomorrow in India, he is going to interact with the Indian delegation and address the community reception, which is hosted by the ambassador here. And also then he will take off to Costa Rica, where we are going to explore a lot of opportunities in tourism. And as we have rightly mentioned in our package, Vice President also unveiled a commemorative stamp. And India has offered to offer the country a bust of Mahatma Gandhi commemorating 150 years of his celebrations. And Paraguayan was very happy to accommodate a space. They also felt the need to spread the spirit of Mahatma Gandhi in this region, Smriti.
Thank you so much, Raj, for joining us and giving us all those details and ground report from Paraguay. And moving on, Union Home Minister Rajnath Singh launched 28 major infrastructure projects of the Central Armed Police Forces and other central police organizations on Wednesday. Spread over 17 states, the projects cost nearly 1,900 crore rupees. The 28 major infrastructure projects inaugurated by Home Minister along with CRPF, BSF, CISF, ITBP and SSB, besides the Delhi Police and other central police organizations. The projects include non-residential buildings, residential quarters and barracks. The Home Minister also said that the central government has been taking various measures to enhance the capacity building of the Central Armed Police Forces. The government has also approved purchase of 200 MiG flats and 582 LIG flats MIG flats and 582 LIG flats from DDA for the Delhi Police. Moving closer towards sustainable development goals, the Niti Aayog awarded 18 aspirational districts for performing well on the SDG parameters. Assam's Hailakandi and Jharkhand's Kondagaon district topped in the ranking of aspirational districts for December-January period of 2018-19. Three districts of Jharkhand, Chatra, Sahibganj and Hazaribagh topped the rankings in health and nutrition parameters. Sahibganj and Chatra, along with Sonbhadra in Uttar Pradesh, also emerged as top three ranking districts on the education parameter. The Delta rankings measures the incremental progress made by 112 aspirational districts across six developmental areas, including agriculture and water resources, financial inclusion, skill development and basic infrastructure.
जो सबसे अच्छी डिस्ट्रिक्ट आई है उसको और जो दूसरी बेस्ट डिस्ट्रिक्ट आई है और पांच क्षेत्रों में जो डिस्ट्रिक्ट आई है उसको हम सबको चैलेंज रूट पे सेलेक्ट करते हैं। और चैलेंज रूट होता है जिसमें सारे डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स आपस में कम्पीट कर रहे हैं और उनको आज हम लोगों ने अवार्ड किया है। तो सारे डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स में बहुत बदलाव आया है और बहुत ही क्रांति आई है इन डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स में, हर क्षेत्र में ये डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स आगे बढ़े हैं।
A parliamentary panel on Wednesday confronted social media giant Facebook over its alleged inability to prevent misuse of its platform during elections. The Parliamentary Standing Committee on IT, headed by BJP MP Anurag Thakur, posed questions to Joel Kaplan, VP Global Public Policy Facebook. The 31-member panel met to hear the views of the representatives of the Facebook and its affiliates, WhatsApp and Instagram, on safeguarding citizens' rights on social online news platform. Facebook gave a commitment to the committee that the identity, location and who paid for advertisements will be available on a special web page for users. Thakur questioned the Facebook representative over insensitive tweets and public comments by Facebook employees, to which Joel Kaplan apologized. The panel asked the Facebook to respond to the concerns raised in writing. A high-powered advisory panel formed by the government has identified 9 national missions, including applications of artificial intelligence, to address major scientific challenges to ensure India's sustainable development. These new programs are being implemented to build on country's rich cultural and traditional practices and to position India as a pioneer in cutting-edge areas of science and technology. Here are the details.
As part of an exercise to leverage scientific research for societal benefits, the Prime Minister's Science, Technology and Innovation Council has announced 9 mission mode projects in areas ranging from biodiversity to artificial intelligence. Addressing the event, Principal Scientific Advisor Professor K. Vijay Raghavan informed that the Council will work on identifying solutions for problems through technology and innovation.
Remember that all these missions came about over the last 3 years of the group of scientific secretaries working together and seeing what is important. So the PSA's office is now only the next step in that process. So the ministries are very important, very enthusiastic. We have also taken up multiple missions ranging from deep ocean, from artificial intelligence, to natural language translation, health, agriculture, biodiversity and so on.
The 9 missions announced by the Principal Scientific Advisor are natural language translation, quantum frontier, artificial intelligence, national biodiversity mission, electric vehicles, bioscience for human health, waste to wealth, deep ocean and Agni, accelerating growth for New India's innovations. Each mission will be led by a ministry and will engage with international and national institutional partners.
Ayushman Bharat mission, as also in general, you know, health delivery, needs to be based on evidence. That evidence currently is based on patients going to hospitals, and better understanding of the patient's history will only help that decision. So the Bioscience for Human Health mission, which will have a major genomics component, will help get data which will allow a patient to get better advice, because the technologies to track that person's health history will be available to that patient and the patient's information can be used in decision making.
Through these missions, the Council aims to facilitate the process of collaboration and focus needed to solve complex problems in a reasonable time frame. The Council is also working towards enabling access to teaching and researching materials in different areas of science and technology in different Indian languages through a combination of machine and human translation. Aruna Thakur's report for Rajya Sabha TV.
And that's all we have for you in this edition of News Tonight. Thank you for watching. Namaskar.